Hello, I'm FKX, Toy Cat, and almost every single good seed that has come out of Minecraft happens because someone types in no seed for Minecraft and they get a really good world that they share with everyone else. And today I wanted to share my particular example of that because I've been playing the random seed glitches category for Minecraft Bedrock, trying to beat the game as fast as I can, and I found a seed today that is not only handy and will allow you to beat the game a lot easier than normal, but it's just an incredible and very weird seed that I think you're going to want to check out, and that's why I'm including it in today's Seed Sunday. Seed Sunday, by the way, is the weekly series where I show you seeds for Minecraft that are particularly interesting and worth checking out in some way. But let's dive straight into this video because, as you can see, this is the spawn area. I actually didn't like the spawn too much for speedrunning, but it's pretty great if you want a spawn that gives you access to wood, gives you access to coal, gives you access to iron, all immediately exposed on the surface, no scary caves to go into. But the other reason it's great is because there's a huge plains biome that leads you over to this village over here. So this village, you know, that you can see is immediately visible from spawn, is really, really great because of the fact that it slightly goes onto this mountain, which means you get this kind of weird inclined village. I mean, in most villages, pretty darn flat. It tries to do it this way, but this village generates a bunch of islands for the blacksmith, for instance, which I think is very interesting. It generates, you know, this over here for this house, and then it generates, as you can see, with some very weird islands for the hay bales and indeed for just single post. And if you think about this post in the lore of the village, the villagers climbed up the mountain with their supplies to build this thing, and they just lit up this one little island and nothing else. Also, they keep their hay bales hidden away in a place they can't access. You know, they're like squirrels burying their nuts for the winter, except they put their hay bales on a mountain. I don't understand it, but yeah, this is a great way to access yourself if you really want to. An immediate chest, which can contain obsidian, diamonds. In my case, it was both obsidian and diamonds. It was pretty great, but also some lava and iron golem. And then, just in case that's not good enough, there's a mountain right behind it, which is pretty easy to climb because of the whole village thing. And yeah, mountains are a great way to view the world around them. And in my case, it gave me view of the second village. So there is a second village over there, but if you're paying attention, and just in case it's something you want, there is also access to a pillager tower along the way. So I'll show you that just in case it's your thing, because here in this tiger biome right here, you know, lovely little place, we can find ourselves this right here, a pillager outpost. And again, same things happen with the pillager outpost. It's on a hill, an existing mountain, which means we can see there is a nice little cage over here, which is not that vertical, but then there's this cage with an iron golem inside, more iron if you can kill him. And let me tell you, killing an iron golem while he's trapped inside a cage, very easy. He can't respond in the slightest. So yeah, if you want to get some free iron, right over here. Want to get yourself a crossbow or some arrows and some dark oak logs, you can totally do that too. But then you can move on to a second village if you so want. Again, more access to hay bales if you really want them. But let's assume you don't care about the second village. I mean, you should care about a second village. I cared about it for the speedrun. But just in case you don't, you're like, no, Toy Cat, you said this seed was great for being Minecraft. Even if you don't care about villages and the free stuff they offer, the food and everything else, allow me to show you something pretty interesting you find in this mountain biome. It's pretty easy to miss, so make sure you focus on the coordinates. As with every Seed Sunday, coordinates are in the top left of the screen. Here you can see there is a ruin portal kind of dug into the side of a mountain, again following that same trend of it's in the side of a mountain for whatever reason. And here you can see there's a chest which can contain all sorts of goodies, and there is a ruin portal which is just missing a couple of blocks, and then it's ready to be turned into a perfect portal. So two blocks of gold, a free chest, a almost finished portal, and that is just on top of everything else we get so far. But in case you do go through the portal, which again, you have to remove this block, you have to add this block right here, and you have to make these blocks both accessible, which is easy enough to do, just like that, we've done it. But this ruin portal also has one of the most perfect nether spawns I've seen all week. I have loaded up 111 seeds in this past week. Seriously, 111 of them. And over that past week, this is my favorite nether of all of them. And I'd say that in terms of like how easy it is to get past, because you don't need to know coordinates. You just need to know that if you go this way, vaguely, you'll find a nether fortress. That's right, not only do you spawn in the warp forest, but the nether fortress is in the warp forest as well. This means in the same place, you get zombie piglins, wither skeletons, blazes, and endermen. So that's terrifying on one level. I'll admit, who wants that? It's scary. But on the other level, it's like, man, that is a lot of mobs all in the same place. You can kill both blazes and endermen, you know, like at the same time and get the two key parts of Minecraft, blaze rods and ender pearls. But the other cool thing about this nether that you probably won't pay too much attention to, but might be great if you do want a slightly longer term outlook, is if we do go over to this direction right over here. So again, check coordinates in the top right if you so wish. There is this really nice place where the crimson forest meets the warp forest. These are the two best biomes in Minecraft, in my opinion. They're the two best parts of the nether update, like in terms of biomes, and I think being able to see them side by side is great. Have access to the hoglins and the piglins, have access to everything else. All of the nether is your oyster, but even better, if we go back to the nether portal, so your nether portal will spawn in the same place if you use that rune portal right over here. You might think that warp forest, crimson forest, and your nether fortress all immediately accessible. You might think that's good, but what if I said that we just go backwards, so we climb up this hill, we go over here, and then we kind of come down here, then what you'll notice is, oh, it's the same crimson forest. It's actually the world's smallest crimson forest biome. It is 2 blocks wide. Which is pretty funny. But then if we look past that crimson forest biome, it's just a, you know, if we stand on this thing, it's a good way to look at the fact that just over here, there is a bastion. That's right, a piglin bastion. And it's not just any bastion, although any bastion is already quite the prize in my opinion. It's actually the bastion, which one of my favorite types actually, it's the bastion which contains the magma cube spawner. So magma cube spawners are interesting by themselves, I'll admit. I personally haven't found it, you know, like I don't use them, but I'll admit having access to a spawner for magma creams, really great. But the way greater thing is all of these gold blocks, which admittedly are right under the thumb of the magma cube spawner. The access to, you know, potential diamond armor, like here's diamond armor protection one, here is ancient debris, here's a bunch of iron nuggets, that's really, really great, right? And yeah, just having access to all these chests, it's super, super dangerous. If you want to beat Minecraft fast, do not come in here. I mean, you will die. That's just a fact of the matter, to be honest. But if you want to get some scraps, if you want to come here later, if you want to get a magma cube spawner, all of those things are available right here. Also, because it's the, just in case you don't know this one, it's the one with the bridge, which also has gold in it. Also, if you go back over here, you'll find there's some gold hidden on the back of this thing. So if we look up, you'll notice how there's even more gold. Basically, this is the gold structure of choice. This is the ideal biome if you want to have a lot of gold and a magma spawner, and it's pretty close to spawn. Seriously, it's tricky-ish to get there. You'd have to mine through some netherrack or throw some ender pearls, but still, pretty easy to do, pretty fast to do, and it gets better. You might be thinking, Toycat, you had some pretty great luck with your seed right there. I'm sure it can't get any better. And although this, you know, ideally would have been closer, I did start throwing eye offenders and I found something pretty great when I headed in this direction. So the eye offenders led me this way and I was like, huh, it's across a tiger biome. Huh, it's across an ocean. And you know, again, like this was taking a lot of time. I'd gone out the nether at 30 minutes, but I was kind of worried that I wouldn't be able to. I was like, huh, this is sure starting to drain me, especially when the ocean just took forever to cross. It's a big ocean, you're gonna be taking hundreds of blocks, but let me tell you what's on the other side is worth it. Because once you cross this ocean, do you know what you find? You find a plains biome, and then yeah, that's right, more ocean. So this is one of the very interesting spawns in Bedrock where a stronghold does not generate below a village. There is no village within any distance of this thing close enough for it to spawn, and that means that it just tries to spawn wherever it can, except Bedrock doesn't have the same conditions of trying not to spawn in an ocean. So what you get instead is this. Do you spot it? You might not spot it, so allow me to illuminate that for you. Here you can see, this is the stronghold. It is the most ridiculous stronghold I've seen in a while. As you can see, this is the origin of the thing. This is where it tries to generate the kind of starting staircase. So as you can see, it's a pretty reasonable start. It's normal enough. And then you can follow the whole thing through, except where there would normally be a hole that just leads to stone, the stone leads to the outside world. This means you can easily explore the entire thing. No, we're not going to mention the shipwreck. This means you can easily explore the entire thing very, very easily and look around and be like, okay, so I want to get out of here. How do I do that? You just kind of either, you know, use one of these many exits, or even if you want to, you can just see like, oh, we break 2 blocks anywhere, and then we can get some, you know, like direct access to the water. It's incredible how this works, but making it even more incredible is the fact that this end portal room is so easy to reach. There is literally an out access to the outside world right here, right next to the land. It is great. I personally think having a village above it is handier because you can get beds if that's how you're gonna kill the dragon. But as far as the easiness of this thing, it's unrivaled. Also, you know what? Okay, I'm gonna mention it. So here you can see the stronghold looks a bit weird, doesn't it? I mean, it's got a weird chandelier in a room you wouldn't expect. And also, what's that? There's a weird upside down thing here. So because the game isn't really used to having strongholds down here, there's the interesting combination, you know, getting loot in a stronghold, that's normal, that's fine. Everyone's used to that. But what you're probably not used to is being able to go from the stronghold into the shipwreck. It's very, very weird. It's very, very wacky to dig down from this thing and to see that. But you better believe if you want to get some leather pants for protection to help you against the dragon or some suspicious stew, you can get that as some last minute supplies. I think it's weird, I think it's wacky, but I love that this is genuinely how the stronghold is. Also, the stronghold goes pretty low down over here, and you can see just how weirdly this thing generates. It's fun, because usually you don't get to see the stronghold from an outside imagery. There's no spectator mode on Bedrock, so you have to do commands if you want to see that. Nope, not over here. In this particular game version, all you have to do is just go to this seed with this particular stronghold, and it is crazy to me just how this happened. And just in case you're curious as to how far away from a village it had to generate for this to even be possible, because it seems dumb, like why did it not generate under a village? That's the thing Minecraft Bedrock Stronghold tried to do, to try and keep them grounded in some way so you're not on a wild goose hunt. And interestingly enough, I decided to look it up, and as you can see, the nearest village is at 1864. That is 1,000 blocks away on the x-axis this way and 400 blocks that way. In other words, 1400 blocks is the nearest stronghold to here, so you can see why it didn't go through with that. Also, you can see there's a lot of other weird things just around in the area. Lots of structures mixed together right here in ways that you probably don't expect, and I think it's just a beautiful, fun thing to check out. And I love that this happened by pure chance while I was speedrunning. If you're curious, I got 58 minutes and 33 seconds. It was a pretty good run. I liked it a lot, but you know what I also think? I think we could have done better. And that's why, despite this being an amazing speedrunning seed, despite this being one of the best that it's going to be hard to top, I think that with better skills, or ideally even better luck somehow, I think we can top this. And my plan is to keep running random seeds until we do. So yeah, if you want to join me on those streams, Streamus is starting soon, a yearly series on the channel, where for December, I try to stream as many days of the month in December as we can. And it's 9 p.m. UK time. This system will tell you what 9 p.m. UK time is on screen right now. She can also make you a book sandwich if you want, an enchanted book with sharpness and riptide. By the way, it's a small thing, but in my run, I got unbreaking and I got mending on my enchanted book. It was an incredible small little detail. But yeah, that was a perfect like survival run that I just so happened to use to beat the dragon in 58 minutes, and I'm hoping we can do even better soon. If you're excited about that as well, you can get 15% off using the code SPEEDRUN at toycatmerch.com. That's right, we got some ugly sweaters, but more importantly, I hope you will enjoy this video. You can like it if you liked it, share if you really liked it, subscribe if you're around here, and I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.